What's up, my DoorDash gang? What's up, my Grubhub gang? This is your boy, Kingfish, a.k.a. Big Owl, coming at you with another video. What it do, family? Hope everything is good. Today is Monday. Yes, sir. Keeping it real Monday. Today, we're going to keep it real all day long. Got to keep it real with you guys. I'm a little wild, guys. The job wore me out last night, man. That is the truth. I ain't even gonna lie, man. They got their money worth out of me last night. So much to do. Man, I am so tired, man. But the beat goes on. All right, guys, if you're new to the channel, today is Keeping It Real Monday. But today, you get to keep it real. You know what I mean? Today, if somebody get on your nerves, you're going to let them know. Hey, man, not today. Keeping it real today, man. You're getting on my nerves. You know what I mean? You feeling somebody, say, look, man, not today, man. I'm not feeling you today, man. Any other day, but not today, player. So go on, man. You're not trying to be nasty. You're not trying to be rude. You're just keeping it real, man. If you don't have a day that you keep it real or you set goals and expectations like that, people will run over top of you. But I like Monday because Monday sets the tone for the week. And Monday is a day that you got to keep it real, man. You done had a great weekend or you done had a terrible weekend. You know, something didn't go right. And people don't care. You know, some people are very selfish. They want to use your time, utilize your time, utilize your effort and whatnot to make their day good. They don't care that you had a bad weekend or nothing like that. So today, guys, just keeping it real Monday all day long. You know? That's how you got to do it, man. Had a good day yesterday. Did okay. I didn't do as many orders as I like. But I did get some information, family. I went to a customer house. And she informed me that on some of the Walmart orders, that they are missing items. So I had to inform her that we cannot count the items that they have. And she said every time she did it, she got a Walmart order, she was missing two or three things. I said, ma'am, you have to call Walmart because y'all call Walmart to get the order. DoorDash just sent us there to pick it up. But I know there's no way I'm going to sit there and count 86 pieces or whatever. You can't do it. You don't know what they order. So I was just telling her, she got a little upset. I was just telling her, I was like, man, there's no way that you can expect a Dasher to sit there and count out 86 or 100 and some pieces. You know, not knowing what it is. She said, but I tip very well. I said, you tip very well. I was like, well, I ain't see it on the app. She said, no, I tipped like $10. But her order wasn't $10. Her order was like, I think it was like $9 and some change. So I'm gonna have to look into that. So I gotta snoop around because she told me exactly how much she tipped. So I gotta check it out. Not saying they did anything wrong. I just don't think she tipped, to be honest with you. I've been dealing with her for a long time. She has never tipped me on the app person. But I was letting her know, even though she tipped, there's no way we can sit there and count out all them pieces because it's not a checklist that you can go by. Two items could be considered as one. You know what I mean, guys? It's just too much. So DoorDash, work on your Walmart. So next time I go to Walmart, I'ma ask them, if y'all have missing items, how do y'all, what did y'all do? Do you take it off, or did you credit the customer? How do y'all do it? How did DoorDash know that something is missing? I'ma find out that information, cause she's a good customer, she just don't tip. She says she do, but I ain't never seen. So I have to find out how they do it. I don't like giving people information if I don't know. You know what I mean? If I know, then I'm okay. I got so many shout outs that I need to do, man. I'm getting bad on my shout outs because, you know, I love shouting you guys out, man. Y'all are some crazy people. I thought I was crazy. I gotta get that coffee. You can hear it in my voice. You know what I mean? I'm laying back down today, guys. You can bet your A on that. Pennylow 416, shouting you out. Thank you for the comment. Girl, a dancer all around the world, girl. You was venting. You was letting everybody know what was going on. Though that's really pissed you off. All right, we got a light. That's right. I'm gonna get my coffee. I don't care if I am in the lane. I'm standing this lane. Come on, change. All right, about time you change. I can smell that coffee, boy. I love when I get the close to Dunkin' Donut, man. You can smell that coffee. I get close to Starbucks and start sniffing that coffee and burn my nose. Lynn Dorn the Dude said, don't you start, Kingfish. I was talking about Starbucks. She said, don't you start. You know, Dunkin' Donut coffee, when you smell it from a distance, it will wake you up. Starbucks coffee, when you smell it from the distance, you're looking for a fire truck because something smell like it's on fire. Smell like something burning. It don't smell fresh like Dunkin' Donut. I'd be like, dang, is somebody call something on fire? Landon the dude gonna kill me, guys. She love herself some Starbucks. So I'm take opportunity to get her. Yeah. You'll never see a bird or any kind of living animal around Starbucks because they scared they're going to get burnt up. But Dunkin' Donut, man, you got ducks, birds, you got everything around that joint. All right, guys, I'm going to get my coffee. I'll be back. I'm back, family. I'm going to do some shout-outs real quick while I'm here. Trini, I got another 10, man. Homegirl, just the one that did it for me the first time. She's a little tyrant. She's a tyrant in the making, man. She just listens, man. She listens. I ain't want to start my truck up here. All right, guys, we're going to do some shout-outs. I haven't did shout-outs in a long time. Dark Phaser, what's up, man? Shouting you out. I love that comment about... Doc Phaser said, everybody was cold food fighting. DoorDash was fast as lightning. Beer. I like that. That's a good saying. Showgirls around the world, a dancer. Man, she or he, I think it's a she. I'm not for sure if you're a male or female showgirl. But, man, you let loose in the podcast, man. I wish you would have been on because you had brought up all the issues, man. You brought up a lot of issues. You was venting. Hot dang. Will Markley, shouting you out from D.C., from the DMV. Talk with T. Tomorrow, I'm shouting you out. Jay Dickles, shouting you out. Charles Brewer. Shouting you out. Sam, what's up, man? I'm shouting you out. Let's see. Acer Lima, shouting you out. Elizabeth, shouting you out. Is it Laura Mitchell? Whatever, I'm shouting you out. Big Rick, always shouting you out. Ben, but don't break, shouting you out. Liz Buggers, shouting you out. My sister Benita, I'm shouting you out. Trini DC, man, call in. Trini, I'm shouting you out. Alex, Mark. Oh, I think it's... I ain't gonna try to mess up your name. But Corey, shouting you out. Chris, what's up, man? Shouting you out. Jack, shouting you out, man. I think it's Athena, shouting you out. Penny Loaf, 416, shouting you out. Demi, how you doing, shouting you out. Luna, shouting you out. Lindsay, shouting you out. You should be getting your shirt soon. Scott Burlows, what's up, homie? I'm shouting you out. Kimberly C, what's up, girl? I'm shouting you out. Thank you for correcting all my words. I appreciate it. MP Daughtry, shouting you out. GWOP, God works over people. Shouting you out. Art Time Time Art, what's up, crazy man? I'm shouting you out, man. How you doing? I can't wait to meet you. The man that gave me the Brazilian soda, I'm shouting you out. Motown YB, shouting you out. Desmond Shepard, what's up, man? I'm shouting you out, man. Rod D, I'm shouting you out. Jeffrey Atkins, Miss Jackie. I got two jackets. I'm shouting both of y'all out. I don't care. All right, guys, that's it for my shout out. Come on, Big Bird, don't do me like that. Don't tease me. Somebody gonna park a shopping cart right in the middle of the road. Man. I was coming home last night, man. I seen this little, I seen this Ford Focus, man. He was flying. Phew! It was raining, pouring down raining. I said, man, somebody, he either gonna have an accident. I ain't mean to speak it or nothing like that, but I said, he either gonna have an accident or he gonna get pulled over. Guys, why he had both? He had an accident and the cop was right there. He had, I don't know if he got, what is it called when you get water? I don't know if he hydroplaned or what. But, he tore that thing up. He was okay because they put him in handcuffs. I don't know if he was running for the cops. I don't know if he was drunk. But I'm just glad that he didn't hurt nobody. And, you know, because at the speed he was going, guys, it's raining. I'm doing 40, 50 miles per hour. This guy was doing at least 80 to 100. And it was pouring down raining. He shook Big Bertha. Big Bertha was like, what the hell was that, a jet? I said, I don't know, babe. But we ain't going that fast. She said, I know that's right. Bertha be in the hospital if I try to do 80 or 100. Yes, sir. Last stop of my baby is the nursing home. That's how long I'm gonna keep it, boy. Guys, I tell you, it's nice when you keep stuff for so long that you get a chance to appreciate it. You know what I mean? I learned this in high school. I had a buddy of mine, Caucasian buddy of mine. His name was Henry. In high school, right? And I used to always get on Henry. He watched my video so I could use his name. I always get on Henry. I used to tell him, I said, Henry, man, why do you wear your shoes till they fall apart? He said, I'm going to tell you something, Lee. He said, one thing my mother taught me, he was a doctor. He said, one thing he used to always say, one thing my doctor mother taught me is how to appreciate what I have. Because, you know, when you don't have a lot, you got to learn how to appreciate. And that right there just woke me right up, guys. That woke me right up. When you don't have a lot, you have to appreciate what you got. And sometimes you can't judge a book by a color. And you know what I start doing, guys? I start appreciating my clothes, my tennis shoes. I ain't lying, guys. I got jackets that I had forever. And they still good because I appreciate them. I take care of them. You know what I mean? You can have something from the 90s. You can have something from the 80s. As long as you appreciate it and take care of it, it'll do you good. You know what I mean? I got a members only jacket. Might not see me wear it, but I love looking at it. Y'all remember the members only jacket, man? When they came out, man, they went viral. I used to have a red one and a black one. That members only jacket was the bomb, man. I remember everybody used to buy the MCM leather jackets. Then I had the Louis Vuitton jacket, but that got stolen. You know? I remember when the leather pants was real popular. Everybody used to have an MCM The black and white MCM leather pants and the black and white MCM jacket, you know. Some of that stuff was straight out of China, but hey, you ain't know no better. Some of it's knocked off. But what I'm trying to say, family, if you got an old ride, if you got something that people look at you and just like, wow, she's still driving that or she still have that, man, just look back at them and say, I appreciate what I have. You know? You riding around on an $800 a month payment, I'm appreciating my ride that I had since 1999 or 2000. You know what I mean, guys? You don't need nothing new. You don't have to go buy a brand new car to be accepted in this world. Guys, take care of what you got, man. Who want to make a payment every month? Life is too hard, man. It ain't like back in the days where money went a long way, where you could have a $400, $500 car note and you know, all your bills are paid. I got a guy, well, not this job. I had a guy that I used to work with and bought the 745, paying $800-something a month. And he told me that, and I said, look, I'm not judging you or anything, but you crazy as hell. Ain't nowhere in the world I'm putting $800 a month on a vehicle just to look good. Ain't nowhere in the world. And this is my point. He was like, well, I'm making good money. I like, are your bills based on overtime or is it based on 40 hours? He said, oh, no, I need my overtime. I said, overtime, they can take that at any time. So he was like, nah, we always get overtime. Right now you do. But you best believe, man, you got to get your bills down to 40 hours a week. Let your overtime be your savings money. I'm trying to teach the young blood. But make a long story short, man, they cut out overtime, but they cut his overtime down. Everybody overtime down. And he ended up losing his car because he couldn't get, he had a felony. He got a felony while he was at work, but he couldn't get another job. So he ended up losing that. And he come to work, he was like, Mr. Al, you was right, man. He was like, man, I shouldn't have never got that car because, man, without the overtime, I can't afford it. But he was smart. He went out and bought him something nice, but it was, he ended up buying it straight out. And he listened what I said. You know, I gave him some advice. Keep, if you want to live right, guys, you got the budget. You got to keep your, you got to understand something. Overtime is a gift that can be taken at any time. You know, when I used to get overtime, man, I used to take my overtime, I used to take my base pay and put that, you know, pay my bills. My overtime money, I used to just put that straight to savings. You know? Because I got tired of being broke every payday. And I still, to this day, I pay myself every week. Before all my bills get paid, I pay myself. And with that money, I do other things with. My bills are based on, after I take my, I pay myself, my bills are based on that. Whether it's $20, whether it's $10, whether it's $50, that money that you pay yourself, you can do anything you want with it. I just prefer to save mine. And I like doing it, guys, because when my moms call me, when my sisters and them call me, with my cousin, anybody that I deal with on a daily basis or a yearly basis, or my wife come to me and say, hey, baby, we need this, we need to do this, we need this, we need to do that. Bam, there you go, baby. Go ahead, do what you got to do. You know, it feels good. So I just want to share that with y'all, guys. Sometimes you just got to make sure that, in this day and age, you got to be smart. You got to be real smart with your money, because money is not as valuable like it used to be. We talked about it, guys. You remember back in the day, early 90s, early, you know, 80s, late 80s, $20 Man, you had $20, man. You was straight. Hell, you was straight. I'm talking about if you smoke cigarettes, you got a chance to buy your cigarettes. You got a chance to buy some food. You got a chance to do anything you want to do. You know what I mean? Yeah, you can put $10 in a gas tank. You're straight for the rest of the week. You know? $100 went a long way back in the day, man. Shoot, I remember when I was younger, when I was like 16, 17 years old, and I was working. Man, $100 lasts me a week. You know? I'm going to say about 14, 15. Yeah, about 14, 15, I was working. And if I had $100, that lasts me a whole week, man. Back in Baltimore, man, you get you a three-piece chicken box, french fries, hot sauce, ketchup on everything. Man, please. Talk with Tino what I'm talking about. You remember back in the day, them chicken boxes? Man. Hot sauce, ketchup on everything, salt and pepper, hot cup. But, man, I'm ready to drive to Baltimore, man. Everything tastes like chicken. Man, you better go ahead. Chinese restaurant, you can fry some bologna that tastes like fried chicken. Because they cooked everything in the same oil. We used to laugh about that. Like, do your spring roll taste like fried chicken? Yep. Those were good old days, man. It's one thing I missed about Baltimore. Here's a couple things I missed about Baltimore. And I know y'all feel me. I don't have an order. I don't start till 10 o'clock. So, I let my alarm go off. I fell asleep. I woke up. Only thing I can get was 10 o'clock. But, guys, I remember. This is what I miss about Baltimore. Let me say this. I miss sitting on the steps, hanging out with my gang back in the day. I used to miss playing cards. It's never a day that you couldn't find a good spade game in Baltimore, guys. It's all you did. If you want to stay out of trouble and you want to live, man, you had to find you a spade party, spade game, and it wasn't crazy, you know? I miss taking them long rides to the 12th floor, you know, living in a tall building. Don't miss the project. I'm just reminiscing. But there's a lot of stuff that I miss in Baltimore. I miss taking them long walks from the east side to the west side. You know? Used to love hanging on North Avenue. Back in the day. Chocolate City. What you know about Chocolate City, T? Yeah. Green Mountain. Used to hang up Green Mountain, 22nd Street. Green Mountain was off the chain back then, man. A lot of places you couldn't just hang out, like Cherry Hill, Flag House, Perkins. A lot of neighborhoods you couldn't hang out. McCullough Home, because people were always up to no good. All right, family. Thank you for riding with me and seeing me go get my coffee. I forgot to tell you guys, I'm not dashing yet. But I always enjoy talking to you guys. But yeah, guys, if I can give you a tip today, be smart with your money. Because, man, money, a lot of people said money ain't everything. But guys, to live in this world, in this time, this day and time, you gotta have a little something put away, man. You know, if it ain't nothing but for vacation or just to be able to do something for a friend or a family member, guys, please take care of your money, man. Be smart. Pay your taxes and whatnot. All right, guys, I'm going to let y'all dash. I'm going to go drop this video, man. Family, I want to say I love you. Stay safe. Be smart. And put some money away. All right, this is your boy, Kingfish, a.k.a. Big Owl. I'm out, guys. If you're dashing, keep dashing. If you're grubbing, keep grubbing. If you're not dashing, you're not grubbing, you better get yourself some dashing grub, man. And get yourself some Dunkin' Donut coffee. All right, love you guys. Peace.